If I say I'm sorry I stole your car, but I'm still driving your car, then obviously I'm not sorry. You've got to repent. You can't, Jesus didn't die on the cross to give you a sin smorgasbord. That's not a buffet table that you can just do whatever you want now because, right, there's nothing to see here. This is just biblical, Bible-believing Christianity 101. Nothing to see here. You know, it only makes sense to people that are saved. To the rest of you, it's just confusion. That's why you don't understand it. That's why you're drawn to it. Because you want to be saved. Yes, your spirit inside, it loves God. There's a spirit inside, you squash it down. You stomp on it. You stuff it down. Stomp it. And all just to keep on in your sinful ways. But your spirit that God breathed into you, it loves God. It knows God. It doesn't need to learn these things. Everything I've said about is in the Bible. Everything it's in the moral law of God. It's very basic. Trusting and committing. John 3:16. Whosoever believeth. That means trust and commit. If you can't be trustworthy to your partner, as in you're cheating on your boyfriend, you're going to cheat on God. And guess what? I'm going to amp it up a notch. If you're not committed enough to make that woman your wife, young men, you're a whoremonger.
Yes.
And you're not committed to God.
Yes.
It's impossible to be committed to a God you cannot see, and you cannot make a simple commitment to the people around you that you can see. That's simple. That's all in the Bible. It's all right there. You want to have a good life? Trust Jesus Christ. Learn to keep yourself. God will bless you with the... No, it's not about making a sign to Mary. Mary won't help you. You need Jesus. You need Jesus. Not Mary. Not anybody else. There's only one mediator. Jesus Christ. That's right. So, trust and commitment. The gospel is, for God so loved the world, that's past tense. He loved the world 2019 years ago. He sent His Son to die on the cross. That's how much He loved you. But when you forsake that cross with your wretched lifestyle, you don't love God. It's very simple. You make a mockery of the gospel. God so loved the world, but God also is very just. He's got consequences in line for your rebellion. Hell expands itself every day.